Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 10.2, Problem 2. This is Section 10.2, Problem Number 2. It says the average score on the BCC math placement test for incoming students is mu equal to 62 with a standard deviation of sigma equal to 5. The math department feels that offering a math review session to people who take the placement test will increase the average score. A random sample of 100 students that were offered a review session had an average score of X bar equal to 62.9. Is there enough evidence at a 5% level of significance to support the claim that the review sessions improve people's score on the placement test? So this is a hypothesis test. There's a six-step process to determine whether this seems like a reasonable claim or if it's not a reasonable claim. So the six-step process, step one, state the null hypothesis. The null hypothesis will have the symbol mu with some condition of equality. So it could just be equal or greater than or equal or less than or equal to. In this case, it's equal to. So we will say that the null hypothesis, symbol is capital H with a subscript of 0, mu equals 62. That's step one. Step two, state the alternate hypothesis. The alternate hypothesis has a symbol of capital H with a subscript of 1. Put the colon, there's going to be a mu again for the symbol for population average or mean. The same number, this is 62 for the alternate, you're going to have 62 again. Now, between the mu and the 62, you'll have some form of inequality symbol or not equal to. So your three options are greater than, less than, or not equal to. Well, in this case, what are we testing? We're testing the claim that the average has increased, that the average is now greater than 62 because of these review sessions. So I'm going to use a greater than symbol. That was step two. Step three, determine if it's a left-tail, right-tail, or two-tail test. To determine that, look at the symbol in your alternate hypothesis and see which direction it points in. This has a greater than symbol, which points to the right, so this is a right-tail test. The type of test is the same direction that your inequality symbol points to in your alternate hypothesis. So this is right-tail. That was step three. Step four is compute the value of z. And the formula we use is z equals x bar minus mu divided by sigma over square root of n. That's step four. We have to fill in that formula and get an answer. So z equals x bar. X bar, the question said, was 62.9. Minus mu. And the question says that mu is 62. Sigma, the standard deviation of the population, is given to be 5. Over square root of n. N is the size of the sample. So this particular problem has a sample of 100. So that would be n. N is 100. Don't forget that 100 is under a square root. That's a fairly common mistake. So we have the formula filled in. Now we'll do some of the work. So z equals, on the top I can do the subtraction, 62.9 minus 62, that'll give me a 0.9. And in the denominator I'm going to want to take that square root. So I have square root of 100. To take the square root of 100 I get a result of 10, because 10 times 10 is 100. And now I can simplify the fraction in the denominator. Z equals, still 0.9 on the top for now, but 5 over 10 is a half, which in its decimal form can be written as 0.5. And to take the problem to the end, I'm going to do z equals 0.9 divided by 0.5, which is 1.8. So the result of step 4, which was calculate the value for z, we get a value for z of positive 1.8. Again, that value could be positive or negative. You want to pay attention to that too. In this case, it's positive. So step five is look up the value for z in the standard normal chart, the z chart. So to look up something in that chart, first you want to write it so that it has two places after the decimal. So that 1.8 must be written as 1.80. Now I have two places. The next part of that process to look something up in the standard normal chart is split the number to look up into two parts by pulling off the rightmost digit. So that rightmost digit of 0 gets pulled off to the side, now I have the number split into two separate parts. Then after that, I put a 0.0 in front of the rightmost digit that I pulled off. So I have 1.8 and 0.00. So the digits from the left, the 1.8, are what row of that standard normal chart I look in. The digit from the right with a 0.0 in front tells me what column of the standard normal chart I look in. And I see where the row and the column intersect. They will intersect at a value of 0.9641. So that was step 5, look up the value for z. We did. We looked it up. We got 0.9641. And finally, step 6, state your conclusion. And the conclusion will either be reject the null or fail to reject the null. Reject the null means you really do believe that the alternate hypothesis is more likely to be true, not guaranteed, that the test score has increased. Fail to reject the null means you think it's probably still 62. Even though our sample was a little bit higher, it could have been a fluke or coincidental. So that's what we want to determine. Now, there's a right tail test, we had said on step 3. So what you have is a bell curve, a normal curve. The right tail or right end is going to be where your critical region is, 5%. So if you go into the rightmost 5%, that means that you want to reject the null. That probably the test score hasn't increased because of the review session. And if you're in the leftmost 95%, right, because the whole thing adds up to 1, or 100%, 0.05 being in the far right tail leaves you 95 in the rest. If you're somewhere in that 95 region, you're going to fail to reject the null. So the value we got was 9641. That goes past 0.95. So you're in that critical region, which is telling me that we want to reject the null. When you go into the critical region, you reject the null. So you don't word it to say accept the alternate hypothesis. You have to say reject the null hypothesis, which means most likely the average on the placement test score has increased. So the final step, step 6, you want to write reject null. Or you could put H sub 0.